of the press, special guests, and friends of Godfrey Okoye University, especially family members of those who are having their convocation today. I'm here graduating, convoking students, and the other students are here present. Great Go University students! Great Go students! I salute you. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Senate, on behalf of the staff and students of Godfrey Okoye University, I warmly welcome you to this fifth convocation of our beloved university. I welcome the proprietor and promoter of Godfrey Okoye University and Bishop the Catholic Diocese of Enugu, Most Reverend Dr. CBC Onaga, members of the Diocese and Curia here present, priests of our diocese and priests of other dioceses, members of the religious congregations working in our diocese, Chancellor and his entourage, chairman and members of Board of Trustees, members of the Governing Council, law friends of our university. I welcome particularly the fresh graduates of our university who have come from different states of Nigeria to celebrate the conclusion of the academic journey in our university. I also welcome the parents, siblings, and friends of our new graduates. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, in 2016, we decided to change the face of our security on campus. We brought in young and experienced people with leonine agility, razor sharp mental alertness, and intimidating physical robustness. One day, I realized that each time I passed by, I heard their definitely loud greetings, "Monster!" Being unschooled in such a language, I wondered how smart adults could be saying "Monsha," meaning good morning, in the afternoon and in the evening. I bore the seeming linguistic barbarity for some time with my Christian equality until it got to such a point where I exhausted all the grace I had for patience. I summoned the CSO and asked him to explain why his men did not know the distinction between morning and afternoon, or even greeting me with "Monsha" in the morning. He smiled and explained to me that for those of them in the security business, there was no afternoon, evening, and night. It was always morning, he added. According to him, one was expected to be alert every time doing one's work. So for them, every time was morning. I smiled sheepishly at my naivety and ignorance. But then, some fleets of associations started flying across the landscape of my poetic mind. A type of poetic revelation was unfolding itself before me, and I caught hold of the picture. Now, I feel that Monsha is an echo of what Godfrey Okoye University really is. For us here, it is always morning. It is unceasing action. It is being on the hill. We are indeed the Catholic University on the hill. From the day of our birth as a university, we have never hidden our precocity and tremendous speed. We took off like Usain Bolt in his 9.558 seconds race that defied medical and scientific predictions on the boundaries of human speed. And our speed is not reducing in any foreseeable future. There is no dull moment here, and no day passes by without something new revealing its fresh age. Ladies and gentlemen, I will concentrate today on areas where our university has revealed its breathtaking speed and proved that it is indeed a university on the go. Graduates of Godfrey Okoye University, what makes my heart brim over with joy as a pioneer vice chancellor of this university is that my students
especially the graduates, have realized that the university is a university and a field.
They have embraced the speed and unceasing drive to break new grounds in different areas. Statistics available to us show that over 70% of our graduates get jobs within 2 years after their graduation. This is certainly a big achievement when one considers the monstrous volume of graduate unemployment in Nigeria. This ease in getting jobs is the result of the quality of education they receive and their sense of speed, innovation, and creativity. It is, of course, difficult to exhaust the achievements of graduates in this address because of temporal and spatial limitations. However, we are planning to write a book on Godfrey University and its graduates before our 10th anniversary next year. I can only mention some of the most outstanding ones. Obunansi, this particular graduate of our university finished with a first class in economics, and within 1 year after her graduation, she rounded off all her ICAR examinations and has become a chartered accountant. She was the best graduate student last year. She is now a chartered accountant 1 year after graduation. Kennedy, this great graduate of our university has never ceased to do us proud with series of awards. Last year, he won a Jeep worth over 25 million naira, a cash prize of 5 million, and an automatic appointment at the Heritage Bank that organized the nationwide competition on entrepreneurship models for Nigeria. The model developed by him, by Kennedy, was chosen as the best. Chairman Kojoku, who finished the Mass Communication Department, is one of the most celebrated young journalists in Nigeria today with a lot of awards. One can hear her scintillating voice on the urban radio where she works as a top presenter. Doris Aja, who finished here with a first class, got a full scholarship last year to study either in China or in the UK. She is doing her master's degree now in the UK on full scholarship. Dufan Abba won a champion scholarship to study on full scholarship in any UK university. This is the mail she sent me on the New Year Day and met my year. She wrote, "Sometime this year, I became a UK champion scholar. This scholarship award allowed me to study fully funded at any university of my choice in the UK and to network with global emerging leaders from about 110 countries. I chose to study public health at the University of Edinburgh. It is about the most prestigious scholarship worldwide, and I'm also speculated to be the youngest Nigerian champion scholar this year." Chinoyi Wunmare got a scholarship to do medicine in the USA after passing a highly competitive examination. Junior Toyba, who got a scholarship to study at Bowie State University, was named the most outstanding student of Bowie State University in 2017. Michael Okoro also won a full scholarship to study at the New York University. Reverend Father Benjamin Achim, who made a first class in the Mass Communication Department, has been appointed the Enugu National Director of Communications by the Bishop himself. Kasimia Eze, who got admission in the UK immediately after graduation, will be rounding up his PhD program this year. In his mail to me recently, he wrote, "I'm so delighted and excited for this wonderful acknowledgement, and I sincerely express my unreserved gratitude to you, Prof. It has been a wonderful experience here in London. I think my journey at Godfrey University played an important role for adapting faster both in academic and secular life." This is what he wrote. The list is inexhaustible. From our records, over 30 graduates of Godfrey Okoye University are pursuing various postgraduate degrees in different countries of the world and are doing exceedingly well. They all have one thing in common. They are proud of their alma mater and have got an unquenchable burning desire to imitate its excellence and speed in all their undertakings.
One of them once said to me, I am Godfrey Okoye University. Everything about me is Godfrey Okoye University. One thing is clear to me, ladies and gentlemen, with these graduates, the future of Godfrey Okoye University is guaranteed. Godfrey Okoye University, apart from creating a befitting environment for learning and academic pursuit, is also very creative in the way it encourages its students to excel. This year, the Senate approved a title for an outstanding performance called Vice Chancellor for One Day. The winner of this prestigious title is the overall best student in an academic year. The person who occupied the office of the DC for a whole day will act as the Vice Chancellor. In addition to this, the winner of the Vice Chancellor for One Day will study on full scholarship for one academic year. Faculty of Law. During the last convocation, I mentioned our readiness to give birth to the Faculty of Law of our university. Today, ladies and gentlemen, Godfrey Okoye University, true to its breathtaking velocity and precocity, now has its Faculty of Law, which is second to none in Nigeria. Also, this great law faculty has been approved by the National Universities Commission after its rigorous resource verification exercise. Our law faculty, named after Professor Christian Wachibu Okeke, is not only one of the most beautiful faculties of law in Nigeria, but also is poised to become one of the best law faculties in the world. With big heads like Professor Christian Wachibu Okeke, Professor Boniface Okere, Professor E.I. Wogugo, Associate Professor Wogugo, and a good number of international visiting professors of law, and under the strict mentorship of Golden Gate University in the USA, nothing will stop this faculty from being the best. My charge to the law faculty is this: best or nothing. School of Postgraduate Studies. Within 8 years of this colorful life, Godfrey Okoye University is full of smiles again as the National Universities Commission gives its nod to the commencement of the School of Postgraduate Studies. Today, we have 100 students pursuing their postgraduate programs at Godfrey Okoye University. Our PhD program has been designed to mirror Godfrey Okoye University's agility and academic rigor and people. We have kept lecturers who love sedentary life and snail speed approach to academic matters away from our PhD school. Only academics who work with speed and accuracy are welcome. With this kind of defined boundaries of operation, we have ensured that students can finish their studies on record time. Students who prefer the sluggishness of a practice will be advised to look for institutions where they can afford to sleep on their work and research. We have also ensured that teaching and research in the PhD school will be abreast with the best in any university in the world. Justice for the year, Chukwura Convocation Arena. Last year, we started a second convocation arena close to our PhD school and the Faculty of Law. This arena, with its incandescent building, located at the eastern end of our campus, has not only been completed, but also named after a judge with an undisputed record of incorruptibility, moral soundness, and judicial sagacity, Justice Cordelia Chukwura. His speed of completion with this dazzling beauty gives a sense of an excellent university environment. Collaborations. Our university has a philosophy of dialogue, which has been at the background of our continuously and irreversibly stretching out of our hands to embrace other academic, social, and cultural institutions. Since the last convocation, we have added new institutions to our long list of collaborating institutions. We have signed an MOU with UNESCO for an intensive collaboration and exchange of scientific information. Recently, we signed an MOU with Shenyang University in China for an exchange of students and staff. In fact, two of our graduate assistants will be sent to China this year for their postgraduate studies. Finally, in the context of this convocation, we held our second term and gown assembly. Through the town and government assembly, we are extending our collaborations beyond academia to embrace industries and companies. Our university has indeed broken down the wall that encloses students and lecturers in an Ethiopian world isolated from daily needs and challenges of the productive world. We will be looking at the needs of companies and the civil society as we prepare our students for the life after university. Our Oguama campus. Our main campus at Anieke, with its 217 hectares, is a spectacle of beauty and indescribable naturalness. Our Godfrey Okoye University Lake, with its crystal clear water and a ring of palms and virgin forests, sheltering the choir of birds and athletic animals, remains the best public center in our beloved Enugu State. The greatest challenge we have had up until now is the access road to that cynosure. But on the 23rd of January 2018, our God-fearing, pragmatic, intelligent, enviable, compassionate, intuitive, resourceful, unassuming, reliable, and generous governor flagged up the road that led to our main campus at Oguama. Apart from making 500 million naira available for the project, he also directed the Minister of Works to give us all necessary assistance to enable us to finish the project. Our governor has also donated a 500 kVA transformer to the university to ensure stability of electricity supply on our campuses. We thank His Excellency the Governor of Enugu State for fulfilling his promise to our university. I would like to reassure him and the state that we are going to complete the road with our speed and accuracy. There will be no rest until the road project is finished. Furthermore, our special friend, Alhaji Aminu Wasiri Tambua, has also commenced the 2,000 capacity auditorium, which he and his friend promised to build at our main campus at Anieke. This project, according to the contractor, will be completed before the end of July. We thank His Excellency Alhaji Ebele for the generosity and deep love of our university. Finally, we have signed an agreement with a Chinese company for a new design of the entire Oguama campus, which will make it one of the most beautiful university campuses in Nigeria. It is our hope that academic activities will begin at the Oguama campus next year. Work will henceforth continue unstoppably at the Oguama campus until academic activities begin there. After all, we are indeed a Catholic university on the go. Scholarship response. Godfrey Okoye University is always dynamic and innovative. 2 days ago, Godfrey Okoye University Trust Fund was launched and was a tremendous success. A friend of our university, Mr. Walter Lindsay, from his foundation, gave 50 scholarships to Godfrey Okoye University, amounting to over 100 million naira. He's here, seated here. This scholarship trust fund, this innovative idea is to support indigent but brilliant students financially so that poverty will not rob them of the opportunity to develop their God-given talents. It is so planned that with scholarships also extended to international students, the university can attract some of them to study here. A cross-fertilization of Nigerian and international students in the Godfrey Okoye University academic setting will be a good way of enriching our students. Our experience with our international students from Austria and Germany has revealed the huge benefits of having international students on campus. Mentorship program. We have continued our mentorship program in this university. It is a program designed to ensure that no student is anonymous on campus. Every student here is assigned to a mentor who is a member of staff. The mentor stands in place of the parents and ensures that the student finishes his or her studies without any cock and bone storage. To ensure the success of the program, we have added mentorship day to our academic calendar of events. Such a program keeps our students on their toes, talking restlessly at the fringes of their consciousness and reminding them that they are here, they are studying in Godfrey Okoye University, the Catholic University and the Girl. Mass Education Day. We have expressed our sense of community service in different ways. But this year, we have designed a program called Mass Education Day. This is a day in which we plan to go outside the four walls of the university to teach in different places. Rural schools, prisons, adult education centers, nomadic schools, etc. These will be our contribution to the global war against illiteracy and academic poverty. Campus television. The success of our Girl University Radio, which was named the best campus radio in Nigeria in 2016, has motivated us to venture into other media. We have applied for Godfrey Okoye University Campus Television. As soon as we get the license from the National Broadcasting Corporation, we will hit the ground running. I'm convinced that by the end of the year, we will have Godfrey Okoye University Television and the video on air. Hospitality management. In the face of dwindling income from the oil sector, our country cannot afford to stand hands akimbo and watch the economy get washed off and empty into an ocean of forgotten economies. A good university must direct its research and programs to areas that will provide alternative sources of cash for the country. One area where the country can make a strong economic statement is in the hospitality industry and tourism. We at Godfrey Okoye University have